Has we learned formulas of profitability ratio. In this class we are going to learn problems of profitability ratio. Look at the board. Sum number one, calculate gross profit ratio. Given is revenue from operation, cost of revenue from operation, purchases are given. They are asking gross profit ratio. So ratio number one, they are asking gross profit ratio. Gross profit ratio formula, gross profit divided by revenue from operation into 100. Revenue from operation given in the question. So we have to find gross profit. We have to find gross profit. Formula for gross profit is revenue from operation minus cost of revenue from operation. Revenue from operation given in the question 1 lakh. Cost of revenue from operation also given in the question. So our gross profit is 20,000. Now we can apply the formula. Our gross profit is 20,000. Revenue from operation is 1 lakh into 100. So our gross profit ratio is 20%. Then look at the second problem. Calculate net profit ratio. Given us revenue from operation, cost of revenue from operation, administration expenses, selling expenses. They are asking us to find net profit ratio. Sum number two. We are going to find net profit ratio. Formula, net profit after tax divided by revenue from operation into 100. In this case, revenue from operation given, we have to find net profit after tax. What is the formula? Net profit after tax formula is, revenue from operation minus all the expenses my plus other income. So from revenue from operation we have to deduct all expenses, then we have to add other income. So revenue from operation given in the question 3,50,000, we have to deduct all the expenses. So cost of revenue from operation is the expense, its value 1,50,000. Next, administration expenses is the expenses we have to deduct. Next, selling expenses also is an expense we have to deduct. No other incomes are given. So no other incomes are not given. So what we have to do? 3,50,000 minus 2,10,000. So our net profit is 1,40,000. Now we can apply the formula. 1,40,000 divided by revenue from operation is 3,50,000 into 100. So our answer is net profit ratio is 40%. Next, we are going to learn the third ratio. Following is the extract of balance sheet as on 31st March 2018. Equity and liability, shareholder fund given, non-current liabilities are given, current liabilities are given, total liabilities, net profit before interest and tax 25,000, calculate return on capital employed. They are asking return on capital employed. We can say ROCE or we can say return on investment. In short, we can say ROI. The formula for return on capital employed, net profit before interest and tax. Before interest and tax divided by total capital employed. Total capital employed into 100. In this case, net profit before interest and tax are given. Net profit before interest and tax. Net profit before interest and tax are given. Its value 25,000 is given. We have to find total capital employed. Total capital employed. The components are preference share capital, equity share capital, reserves and surplus, debenture, bank loan, loan. Yes. Or we can say we can take all liability excluding the current liability. So liability side are given. We can take shareholder fund and long term debt. We can exclude current liability. So what are all the components? First one, we can take share capital. Share capital, its value 70,000. Next, share capital we can take. Next, reserves and surplus we can take. Reserves and surplus we can take, value 25,000. Then we can take long-term borrowings. Long-term borrowings. We can take long-term borrowings. Value 30,000. So our total capital employed is 1,25,000. Now we can apply. Our net profit before interest and tax is 25,000. Total capital employed 1,25,000 into 100. So our answer is 20%. So our return on capital employed or return on investment value is 20%. Students, let me learn two more ratios. Students, let me learn operating cost ratio and operating profit ratio. Very important problem. Look at the board. Calculate operating cost ratio and operating profit ratio. Particulars, note number, rupees. Revenue from operation 8 lakh, other income 20,000. If we add these two, we will get 8,20,000. Okay. Then expenses, purchase of stock in trade 4,50,000, change in the value of inventory minus 40,000. Usually, opening stock and closing stocks are given. Sometime change in the value of inventory are given. If change in the value of inventory are given, it may be negative value or positive value. If opening stock exceeds the closing stock, it is a positive value. Sometime closing stock exceeds the opening stock, that we called negative figure. Here, change in the value of inventory minus 40,000. Here, the closing stock value exceeds the opening stock. Okay. Employee benefit expenses 22,000, other expenses 68,000, total expenses 5 lakh. So total revenue minus total expenses will get profit before tax. Then the breakup of employee benefit expenses and other expenses are given. Employee benefit expenses includes wages and salary. Other expenses include administration expenses, selling expenses and loss on sale of fixed asset. Okay, now I am going to calculate operating cost ratio. Fourth ratio I am going to calculate. Operating cost ratio or operating ratio. Formula, operating cost divided by revenue from operation into 100. Revenue from operation given in the question, so we have to find operating cost. What is the formula of operating cost? Operating cost formula is cost of revenue from operation plus operating expenses. Operating expenses is different from operating cost. Operating cost, which include cost of revenue from operation plus operating expenses. First, we have to find cost of revenue from operation. Formula, net purchases minus change in the value of inventory, because here the change in the value of inventory negative item is given. Change in the value of inventory, negative balance is given. plus direct expenses. Plus direct expenses. Okay. Net purchases given in the question 4,50,000. Change in the value of inventory, it shows negative value minus 40,000. The direct expenses, we can go through in employee benefit expenses, we can ascertain here wages are direct expenses. How much? 10,000 that we have to add. So 4,50,000 minus 40, we'll get 410 plus 10,000 equal to 4,20,000. Then we have to ascertain operating expenses. The formula for operating expenses, employee benefit expenses plus depreciation plus office administration and selling expenses. So employee benefit expenses, look at the employee benefit expenses. Already we considered wages for the cost of revenue from operation. So now we can take salary. Salary value how much here? 12,000. That we can consider as employee benefit expense. Then depreciation is not given. Then office administration selling expenses we can see in the other expenses. So administration selling expenses we can take. Administration expenses 20,000. Selling expenses 28,000. Now 30, 40, 60. Now we can apply the formula. Our cost of revenue from operation is 4,20,000 plus our operating expenses are 60,000. Our revenue from operation is 8,00,000 into 100. So 4,80,000 divided by 8,00,000 into 100. We'll get 60%. So our operating cost ratio is 60%. If operating cost ratio is 60%, so our operating profit ratio is supposed to be 40%. Now we are going to calculate the loss ratio, operating profit ratio. Formula: operating profit divided by revenue from operation into 100. We have to find operating profit. So operating profit formula, revenue from operation minus operating cost. Revenue from operation, as we know, 8,00,000 rupees. Already we ascertained operating cost. The total operating cost is 4,80,000 rupees. If we deduct this, we'll get 3,20,000 is our operating profit. So 3,20,000 divided by 8,00,000 into 100 equal to 40%. So our operating cost ratio 60%, our operating profit ratio is 40%. If we add these two, we'll get 100%. So 100% minus operating cost ratio, we'll get operating profit ratio. 100% minus operating profit ratio, we'll get operating cost ratio. Students, here we learned profitability ratio. In next class, we'll solve different problem. Till then, bye and thank you.